We are sure you've heard about the great tragedy that was Titanic sinking back in 1912. But we bet you didn't know these 10 strangest facts about the unsinkable ship. Number 10. Largest moving object. Back in 1912, when Titanic first entered service, it was the largest ship afloat. That is, before it hit the iceberg and stopped floating. The Titanic was 269.1 meters long and 53.3 meters high, looking like nothing but a floating city. The Titanic's huge size even prompted the New York Tribune to run our headline on November 27, 1910, asking, "How can we dock this marine monster when she reaches the port of New York?" However, today's largest cruise sister ships, the Royal Caribbean's Oasis of the Seas and Allure of the Seas, are both 362 meters in length and 65 meters above the waterline, trumping Titanic size easily. We're sure nobody aboard the Titanic would have expected that Titanic would be dwarfed by other ships in the future. But despite the fact that Titanic was the largest ship ever built at the time, it still took 73 years to find its wreckage. Although, that's understandable considering how vast the ocean is. Number 9. Fake funnel. Not many people know this, but one of the Titanic's funnels was fake. The fourth one was only a dummy installed because it made the ship look more beautiful. This was then turned into a ventilation shaft for the kitchen, while the three functional ones were connected to the furnaces producing the smoke. Considering how the ship cost $7.5 million to build, which was a whole lot of money over 100 years ago, you would think they would have settled for three funnels, or at least more than 20 lifeboats for a ship that has thrice the capacity for passengers. The ship also took 3,000 Harlan & Wolff shipbuilders to construct it. Fun fact, James Cameron's 1997 movie about the Great Titanic tragedy had a production budget of $200 million. He could have built over 25 Titanics with that budget, and maybe some of them would have not sunk. Here's to hoping. Number 8. Titanic's interior. The design for Titanic's interior was inspired by and based on the Ritz Hotel, located in London's Piccadilly neighborhood. The first-class cabins were finished in the Empire style, giving off luxurious vibes that you could easily mistake for a hotel, intending for the passengers to forget that they were on board a ship. The Ritz Hotel first opened in 1906, and it still is operating to this day. The only difference between the two is Ritz Hotel would have seen the iceberg a mile away. There were over 800 tons of coal burned to power the gigantic ship every day, and some of the luxuries in the ship included a swimming pool, Turkish bath, squash court, and a dog kennel. Although it's a different matter that most of the people didn't feel the need for a swimming pool once it hit the iceberg. There were many people aboard the Titanic for a peaceful and romantic vacation. There were 13 couples in total who were on their honeymoon. Poor lovers. More of the ship's luxuries included a feast on the Titanic consisting of 10 courses that ultimately turned out to be the ship's final dinner. Number 7. Tragedy predicted. Titanic was given the name of the unsinkable ship, but the tragedy was predicted 14 years before it actually happened. And no, it wasn't The Simpsons that did it. In 1898, American author Morgan Robertson published a novella titled The Wreck of the Titan. Now, the cover of the book featured a sinking ship that looked eerily similar to the Titanic, and the book spoke about a fictional ocean liner that sank due to a collision with an iceberg. Sounds familiar? Not only that, but the ship mentioned in the book was also described as being unsinkable and prided itself on not having enough lifeboats for everyone aboard. We're sure that must ring a bell. Number 6. Another ship could have saved more people. When the Titanic began sending out distress signals, there was a ship called the Californian, which was closer than the Carpathia, who actually came to help. However, the Californian did not respond until it was too late to help. Bet it would have been easier if they had iMessage back then. At 12:45 a.m. on April 15, 1912, crew members of the Californian saw mysterious lights in the sky, which were later identified to be stress flares sent up from the Titanic. They immediately woke up their captain to tell him. Unfortunately, the captain didn't bother losing sleep over the issue and gave out no orders. Since the ship's wireless operator was also busy getting his beauty sleep, the Californian remained unaware of whatever disasters the Titanic was going through. By the time they found out, the Carpathia had already rescued the remaining survivors. The Californian's captain was later in trouble when the United States Senate inquiry and British Wreck Commissioner's inquiry into the incident led to the conclusion that more people could have been saved if the Californian had responded promptly to Titanic's distress rockets, labeling the captain's inactions reprehensible. Looks like somebody got in major trouble. Number 5. Unclear who died. Can you believe nobody knows who exactly died on the Titanic? Although the official number of the dead was 1,503 out of the 2,208 on board, there were over 100 unidentified bodies buried in Fairview Lawn Cemetery in Halifax, Nova Scotia. Since many people traveled under false names and from so many different places, identifying even the recovered bodies proved impossible. Sidney Leslie Goodwin, a 19-month-old boy buried under the moniker Unknown Child, was only identified in 2008. After carrying out extensive DNA tests and a worldwide genealogical search. It was really tragic. Number 4. Drunk Survivor. Charles Johan, the chief baker on the ship, managed to survive the sinking in the most legendary way. While everyone was panicking when the ship started sinking, Johan decided this was the best moment to drink all the liquor he could find so he could brace the cold water, a rather smart move. Once he had enough to drink, Johan started tossing chairs into the water to be used as flotation devices. As the ship went down, he said he wrote it down as if it were an elevator. Probably the greatest move of all time. His smart thinking and damaged liver enabled him to spend several hours in the freezing cold water and still live to tell the tale. Is this a legend or what? Number 3. Famous violin recovered. If you remember the scene in Titanic the movie, where musician Walt Hartley continued to play the infamous violin as the Titanic sank, you would know what we're talking about. Up until 2006, researchers thought the violin was lost in the sinking. However, a woman found it in her attic, which led to 7 years of testing. In 2013, researchers determined that it was, in fact, the same violin upon which Hartley had famously played Nearer My God to Thee while watching the Titanic sink. The violin was sold in the same year for £900,000 in just 10 minutes at an auction in Wiltshire. A bit expensive for just a violin, don't you think? However, it had a guide price of £300,000 and was made famous by Titanic the movie. Number 2. The luckiest woman in the world. Violet Jessop was a British nurse aboard the Titanic when it sank. She grew up in Argentina and was 24 years old when she first boarded the ship. Unlike many others who were aboard the ship when it began sinking, Jessop was ordered up on deck and saw passengers strolling about calmly. She stood at the bulkhead with other stewardesses and watched the women cling to their husbands before they were put in the boats with their children. After a long 12-hour wait, Jessop became one of the people who have been rescued by the Carpathia. This is where it gets interesting. 4 years later, Jessop was aboard the Titanic's sister ship, the Britannic, when it sank in the Aegean Sea due to what British officials later hypothesized as being struck by a torpedo or hit a mine planted by the German forces. Luckily, Jessop managed to survive that as well. And that's not all. Jessop was aboard the Olympic, the eldest of the three sister ships, when it collided with the British warship called the MHS Hawk. Although it didn't sink, it was remarkable that Jessop had been on all three of the unsinkable ships and had survived. Wish we had that kind of luck. Or was she unlucky? Well, it depends on how you see things. Number 1. No dog left behind. One of the biggest tragedies from the entire incident was the fact that there were so many family pets around the Titanic. Although their quarters were opened once the ship began to sink, there were only two pets who managed to survive. One passenger named Anne Elizabeth may have sacrificed her own life in order to save her dog. According to legend, going back to rescue her Great Dane is what probably killed her after the ship began to sink. A woman was also sighted frozen in the water after the sinking, with her arms around her dog. In the end, she was only one of four first-class women who perished. And that's a wrap for the 10 strangest facts about the Titanic. Did we mention any that you didn't know about? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure you like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.